Well, here we go. So, one of the new things that I'm doing is I'm going to take all of the Singing Pumpkin files and the Atmos FX pumpkins, and I'm going to turn them vertical like this. Now, this is not vertical to you, but it's going to be vertical when I put it on the SD drive and put it on the projector. So what I had to do was I had to take all three faces and I had to arrange them. Let me see if I can actually move this out of the way. Oh, I can. So you can see how now they're kind of in a line. Why are they in a line, you ask? Well, first of all, to do this, you had to split them up into three different video files, and then you had to crop each one, and then you had to put the adjustments in there to where they need to be for what I'm putting them on. I will put these numbers, because you can see these numbers right here, are very important. The XY axis and the position, and then the angle will put, that's for this one right here. So I'll put it in this exact spot in your Filmora thing. It'd probably work for every other film editing thing that has at least this, which pretty much every one of them is going to have something like this. It may just say something differently, but this is basically your size, so it's the width and height, and then this is the position on the XY axis of where in the video frame this is. This is obviously zero, and that's why this one says zero. So you have a zero right here, so this would be plus and this would be negative, and this would be plus and this would be negative of the half. I'll put down the numbers for the Singing Pumpkins so far. I'm going to be doing the Atmos FX ones later as well, but I'll put down the numbers for that one and the Singing Pumpkins, so if you want to do this yourself. But here's why I'm exporting them. Now, I'm probably going to get a copyright strike on this, but I don't care. So here we go. Watch.
Landslide, no escape from reality.
Yeah.
Open your eyes, look up to the skies and see.
So what this is actually an inflatable pumpkin stack from Amazon. That's my ceiling fan. So on the front of it, actually could be dual use, is pumpkin faces. They're actually pretty good pumpkin faces for an inflatable. But I needed one that had nothing on the back. And some of them had stuff on the back and some of them I just couldn't tell. This one I was able to find a picture of somebody who had it, and I was able to do... obviously able to get it, and has the hat on. I kind of wish it had the spider webs on the top of the hat, but it's still cool. So there's two things about it. There was a white light in the middle. There was three white lights in there. I clipped the wire on that, but I also kept the wire in there because it actually creates stability with this, because it goes from up here all the way down and keeps it at a straight thing when it's blowing up. This one's really cool because it has tabs right here for the guy wires, so that it will keep it, it should keep it fairly straight. That's the only caveat with doing a projection on an inflatable, is that the inflatable will move. So I'm hoping with the ones on the bottom, because there's ones on all, I think it's all four corners of the bottom, there's a weight in it as well. I'm actually going to put another weight inside. I'm going to put like a couple of bricks in there as well to keep it even more down, and then use the two guy wires on the top to hold it as well. But it will move probably a little bit, but that might still look kind of cool. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to do two things. Is I'm going to put an orange light inside, like maybe a flame bulb, and see what that does. And see if it lights it up too much, because I think a white light is going to light it up too much. If I put a purple light on here, it'll be just like a pumpkin. It's orange, obviously, but I want to see what it does to the projection. And the other option, my friend Kevin told me, is that to take, because there'll be tombstones around it. And so if I put like a tombstone over here, and I have the warm white light over there pointing at the tombstone, it's going to cast a little bit of light onto this on the edge. So I just need to make it so there's no like stark edge where the tombstone would be. So the shadow would be over here of the tombstone, and the edge of the white, warm white light would be over here, and it would light it up just enough. Because my yard is so dark, we didn't realize that having a super pitch black dark yard was actually going to be a tiny bit of a problem. Everybody wants their yard dark with no street lights. There's a problem. We project onto real pumpkins as well. Those pumpkins are going to be very dark. people will be able to walk up to them. There's ambient light enough to know it, but it's not going to be as bright as a regular pumpkin. So there are some things that you might want to actually have a street light for. Maybe not one directly in front of your house. That always sucks. But so that is going to be probably one of the biggest, newest additions. See, like right now, you can't tell it's a pumpkin. And this is how dark it's going to be in the yard, if not even, I mean, this is actually, it's actually even darker than this. So all you would see is just three vertical faces in the middle of nothing. So we've got to light it up somehow. So I'm going to try two different ways, and we're going to see how that looks right now. So I moved the pumpkin faces on the Atmos pumpkin jamboree, and I put them vertical, and then put a projector on them. So now, instead of having three real pumpkins in the yard like this, I've now got this that comes up every night and never have to replace it. So cool. So we also have the animated tombstone over there. He's going. And now we have two new additions as well. Even more new. So there's the spinning projector. Looks kind of bad on that because the blue never shows up really well. But we also have the people up there. Oh, there's the mage. He's up there in the attic, cleaning the attic. Hopefully that this bottom projector will do a better thing here. So those are two. I wonder how I can get this, just see what they are. Oh yeah, so it's that type of face. There you go. That's so cool. And that's next to the creepy lady in the window up there. So I've got one more projection to do, and that's the front window there. I'm gonna do that probably tomorrow at some point. Because I need to put the film around the outside of the window there, and then put the projector on a stand there. So basically the new thing is that I used to put, and I'm going to have to maybe adjust something on it, but that projector case is down on the floor there, and when I put the projector down there, it makes the faces all weird on here, because when I designed the files, they were designed to be head-on, so that would be pointing upward, and it made them look all weird. So I think what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna have to build a new projector housing for that one, being that it's straight on. The other thing I can do is I can just come out here if it's gonna rain. The chances of it raining here are way slimmer in October than it was in Portland, so I literally can go out here and just grab it. But I also don't want somebody just to think they can run off with it, but there's not really anybody in the neighborhood. So that projector there will be on a tripod, basically right behind the angel right there, and it'll be pointing right at the window. So I got to play with that a little bit, so I'll do that probably tomorrow. But I also have the other, there's the face is still there, different eyes now. And then I got this projection here, still, just spiders. So, I don't know which part of the vlog this is going to be in, because I've shot several videos and shot several things of this in the process. As you saw in the first part of this part, was that how I was doing the projection for the pumpkins. If anybody wants to know how I did that, I will probably make a video after Halloween of how I made that video file and some of the numbers, to tell you which numbers to put the basically your X and Y axis stuff. So alrighty, here comes somebody down the street. I should probably back away so they don't see me. So then they can look. They are totally looking slowly. Oh, there they go. The neighbor has put out more stuff too, but he's not lighting it up. So he's got black lights on it, so we'll see if I can get a good shot of that pretty soon. But I am really liking my house this year. I know, I said I wasn't going to do anything big, but you know me, I got to go. I got to go big. So I think other than this projection right here, that'll be it. That's all we're going to do the rest of the year. So I'm going to Chicago next week. So, all right, you're going a little fast. Anyways, I need a fire pit out here too. I'm gonna get my fire pit from my RV and put it right here in my garage, in front of my garage. I'm gonna be a garage fire pit guy. Anyways, so, all right, that's it for this build video. So haunt on.